Yeah, hello everyone. I am Ashish Kapoor and I welcome you on behalf of the AirSim team at Microsoft Research. So the recent successes in machine learning and reinforcement learning have been very impressive, but they have been limited to scenarios such as arcade games, game of Go, etc. Typically closed world situations where your AI agent doesn't need to worry about the exogenous factors such as wind, pedestrians, other cars, etc. So consequently, we at the AirSim team have been thinking about how to take these techniques and apply them to real world tasks such as autonomous driving, flight, robotics, etc. And consequently, the key idea that we've been working on is to create these high-fidelity simulations, which are essentially video game on steroids that are played by autonomous systems agents. So the whole idea being that an AI pipeline, if it has an access to a simulated environment in which it can take actions, and if such a similar environment has high fidelity, then we can hope to train AI systems, which then we can deploy in real world. So what I'll do is I'll ask Shital Shah, who's the lead architect for our AirSim pipeline, to give you a little bit more details about AirSim.
Thank you, Ashish. So we want to show you some of the features that we have built and what you can do with AirSim. So AirSim is an open source cross-platform project. So you can get it right now. There are releases and where you can download binaries. You can start playing with right away. It works on Windows as well as Linux. And here are some of the things you can do with it. So AirSim provides you all this ground truth, depth view, segmentation view, which is very hard to get in real world, and but you can obtain in simulation very nicely. So you can do a lot of computer vision and learning tasks. We have built drones simulation as well as car simulation. So here you can see the city environment, and you can see this big city. This is a relatively big city that we have built, and this is a another environment from Hawaii, Hena Highway, where you can drive the car and you can test your self-driving algorithms. And you can do a lot of detection and object recognition stuff. For example, identifying animals, identifying objects. You can also do a lot of machine learning, reinforcement learning work in AirSim, where you can build your reward function and try out RL algorithms in the open worlds. So this is a great research platform for reinforcement. And there are some examples, stuff we have been trying to do. For example, here, car is trying to learn how to drive without collisions. So with saying that, let me more to my colleague Jim, and he can show you more about the environments.
Thanks, Shital. As Shital indicated, I'm Jim Piavis, and I'm a member on the AirSim team at MS Research. So AirSim actually supports a number of different environments, and since we build on Unreal 4, it's a relatively common skill set that we can actually go out and find on the open market to actually build our environments. The nice thing is that we can rapidly build these out. It just depends on the complexity. As Shital indicated and he showed a little bit earlier, we have a number of different environments that we use. Okay, and these are all constructed using typical modeling tools such as 3D Max, Maya, whatever it takes basically for 3D animation and creation. What you're looking at now is a warehouse environment we did for Toyota Materials Handling for the Hanover Messiah show several months ago. Okay, and it shows several different drones that Toyota was working on and how those might be visualized within that warehouse environment. We can apply reinforcement learning to each of the hero actors within the scene as they teach themselves how to actually maneuver within the warehouse. And this was probably constructed, I think we took a total of about 3.5 weeks and a couple people to actually build this, and it originated on a set of CAD drawings provided to us from the customer. This is a little bit more complex. For those that have been in Building 99, this is the interior, or at least the lower floor of Building 99, which involves both the atrium, the cafe, some of the office areas. And it's a relatively complex environment. Okay, and this environment had to be entirely hand-created, but What we used was a drone to capture roughly 400 to 500 images of the atrium. Okay, and then we reconstructed a point cloud using photogrammetry and used that as very accurate reference material. And then after handing that off to our art team, they're able to actually reconstruct the entire scene over the course of about 3 weeks. And I think we had 3 to 4 folks working on this at any given time. And it actually turned out to be quite a nice little environment. Shital also showed the city environment. We've built an entire city, which includes vehicles, pedestrians, which can be varied place to place. We have weather, particle effects that can be configured within the scene. And we've also been able to support the latest Microsoft Build Conference, which was held about a month and a half ago. We had an interesting activity for the development, for the developers, to construct an AI application leveraging cognitive services to identify objects. And in this case, what we have is our real-world objects in the upper left, the upper right. The upper left is the synthetic images which we built. Okay, those were placed on a soccer field, and then we basically flew a drone within the AirSim application, okay, collecting visual data, which was then sourced through to cognitive services for object identification. And in the end, we were actually able to achieve about an 85% hit rate between the training we sourced on synthetic objects versus the real world. And we think this is very promising in the future, where we can use synthetic environments, okay, to train in for external. Finally, say we do have environments we use for drones. This was actually somewhat of an out-of-the-box scenario with mountains, but what we did is augment it with power lines so that we can start teaching the drone through reinforcement learning how to actually stay on the power lines as you see in the scene. So, you know, we're using a combination of, say, out-of-the-box, which are quickly sourced. We can grab those, and then if we need to do any custom modifications, we can do that to the scene. So the scenes are very extensible. They're easy to create. We can get things turned around pretty quick. And so hopefully this is a pretty good primer on what we're doing with AirSim. Thank you very much.